We're going to know the definition of love and hate because we use those a lot, right? We love our favorite foods. We love our mom. We love our dogs. We love whoever we're dating. And we hate the Patriots. We hate hot dogs. We hate, right? Like, we... Too soon? So we're going to know that. Stick with me. Rip Dan Quinn. We're going to address three things. First, three important facts about bullies, because we talk about bullies all the time. We call people bullies. We feel like we've been bullied, but we don't really address, like, what is it? Like, is it like a person? Do they look like something? We just need to go kick them all out? Like, what is bullying? So we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the choices to go into being a bully. By the end of the day, we're going to address the fact that a bully is not an individual. Okay? If you're not like born a bully, we have to like go hunt them down like some old Western movie. And the last thing is I'm gonna give you three questions. Three questions that you're gonna be able to ask yourself, say, hey, am I actively being a bully? Or is someone else being bullied? Am I being bullied? And what's the next step for themselves? And your mother looks at you while you were being a pill and says, just wait until you have kids. Anyone ever had that said to you? Yeah, okay. All right, so this is that curse coming back on my head. My son Owen is me, 3 years old, and much prettier. He is just a 1,000 miles an hour. Well, this 1,000 mile an hour kid has really one major fear. It's not dogs, it's not roads, it's not heights. It's water. But not just any water. He'll swim. He does not let water go into his ears. Like, try to wash this kid's hair, okay? He goes ballistic. Like demon-possessed Jack-Jack from the Incredible Dragon, like red the face, he goes nuts! Okay, if water gets, he hates rain, he hates showers, he hates mats. Well, Owen, a week and a half ago, got an ear infection. Now, do you know where the medicine for your ear infections goes? Yeah. So Owen woke up in the middle of the night screaming bloody murder. We go with him, right, thinking he's dying, he's holding his ear and he's just screaming. Goes to the doctor, sure enough. It's puffed up, it gets see-through, there's junk behind it. They give us the medicine, go, great, just do this 3 times a day and you'll be fine. So here's the deal. If you were just to witness what happened next, with no context, you would look at us and go, those are people who hate their child. We don't know what's going on. It goes viral on the internet, take their child away, this is horrible. Owen showed us his 3-year-old speed. 100 miles an hour, right? Your medicine is gone. So mom cuts him off in the living room, right? I come in behind, start doing like a shifty dog thing, right? When the dog trying to get away from something. And we tackle him. We get him on the ground, but he's still fully in control of everything but his arms and legs. So he's just going like this, right? And you go like, no. So my wife has to hold down his legs, right? And an arm. I have to pincer him and then hold his head with one arm and medicine, right? The whole time, just going nuts. Drops, let him go. Now, some people might be like, yeah, that definitely sounds like child abuse. Here's our alternative. If I do nothing, my son's gonna be in pain, he's gonna have a continuing infection, and he's gonna possibly have long-term damage. You let that rupture, you lose hearing, and your eardrums do not repair themselves, okay? When it's bulging like that, you only have 2 options, make the infection go away, or let it pop. Yeah, that's gross. Out of love for my son, we did what was best for him. Was it fun? Did we think he was gonna like it? Nope. Right? He hasn't written me a letter like, dear father, thank you for giving me medicine. Right? He hasn't done that. He just knocks over his brother and runs away from me. So it's not like he's super thankful, but out of love, I did what was best for my son. And we want